Thank you very much. First of all, I like to say thank you for such valuable and splendid medal of Cathedra UNESCO. So thank you very much. And from very beginning of my education, training, and early stages of my academic career, I was supported by others, so I would like to share my knowledge, international experience with the students, PhD students, and young scientists from, especially from Eastern Europe, from Ukraine, Kazakhstan, Vietnam, Indonesia, Japan, and Taiwan. So thank you very much. And today also we have 12 students from Kazakhstan, from Women National Pedagogical University, and they came here and they learn, I hope, a lot from this conference. So let me start my presentation. And I will sit, and I prepare also. I was doing this presentation in the early morning today. So okay. So I like to say about the milestones in the perception of people with intellectual disabilities in Poland. And my presentation consists from two parts. And I try to move the presentation. Okay, how can I do it? Okay, thanks a lot. And first part is a brief overview of the most important pieces of legislation that relate to the education of pupils with special needs, including, of course, intellectual disabilities, students with intellectual disabilities. I will draw attention to the most important changes in access to education, resulting in the inclusion of students in the mainstream education. And the second part is my reflection on the changes in the perception of people with intellectual disabilities over the last century since Poland gained independence after 123 years of partitions and start to rebuild and build system of education. And the first most important piece of legislation is the Constitution of 1921. And this act gave the right to education to all students without exception. It can, therefore, it can be said that in the beginning, education had an inclusive dimension. However, the school system was in disrepair at that time, in the beginning of the 20th century, and children with special needs were most often out of the school due to the lack of educational facilities. Even if such children were admitted to school, the teachers didn't know how to teach them. This problem was recognized, and the easiest way, easiest solution was to take these children out of the system. And however, and it's very important to say that In the 90s of the 20th century, intensive training of teachers to work with children with disabilities began. And important role was played by Maria Grzegorzewska, patron of our university. And she became the head of the Academy of Special Education in 1922, and she headed the Academy until 1967. By 1939, it means up to the Second World War, there were over 120 special educational schools for children with disabilities, including about 90 special special schools funded by Maria Grzegorzewska. The system of special education developed intensively throughout almost the entire 20th century. And significant changes in the system didn't place until the 90s of the 20th century. Breakthrough is a directive 1993. And this directive, thanks to this directive, special education system is merged with the mainstream system. And this directive provides for care and education of children with disabilities in general mainstream and integrated centers. Significant changes happen thanks to the education law, which was acted in 2010, and this educational law regulated obligated every kindergarten and school to support children with special needs. Support with psychological and pedagogical support. This law was changed in the following years, 2013, 2017, to 2022. This law distinguished 12 groups of children, students with special educational needs. Among them is, of course, children with disabilities. And you can see this is the children with disabilities, socially maladjusted students, students at risk of social maladjustment, students with behavioral or emotional disorders, gifted and talented students, students with specific learning difficulties, students with language communication disorders, with chronic disease, in crisis or traumatic situation, experiencing academic failures, experiencing environmental neglect connected with the living conditions, and experiencing adaptation difficulties related to cultural differences or to changes of educational settings. And also, this law acted in 2010 regulates education for children and youths in three types of placement, and introduce individual educational therapeutic programs and plan for support development. And children and youth with disability can learn in three types of preschools and schools. And the first is mainstream, of course, education. And now in every mainstream kindergarten school can be obligatory, can they can be special educator. And second type of placement is very unique, I think Polish solution. This is integrative kindergartens and schools, and the proportion of children are such: three children with special educational needs to five children with typical development. And also the third one is special preschools and special schools, and number of children depends on disability, 2 to 16 children. And irrespective of educational setting, special integrative or mainstream preschools, schools, the development of individualized education and therapy program for children with statements of disability is required by the law. Now I think it's very interesting indicators of inclusion according to the data taken from Central Statistical Office 2023. In the 2023 school year, the majority of children with disabilities attended mainstream kindergartens. The indicator is 78%, including kindergartens with integration groups and integration kindergartens. And on the level of basic education, I mean, this is the basic schools with, I'm sorry, with 8 grades, not 6 grades. It's what before, 6 grades, 6 classes, 8 grades. The indicator of inclusion is 76.6%. And the picture is quite different when we talk about the education of young people with special educational needs at the secondary school level, because these children, students, were enrolled in special schools. I try to compare the indicator of inclusion on this level, I mean the secondary level of education, and the data from 2014, and I compare with the data 2033. Indicator is about 15% student included in mainstream education and this level of training. And finally, second part. So this is my just observation and thinking, and I distinguish changes in the approach to people with intellectual disability over the last century, and I just divided them in three parts: in the comprehension of the essence of disability, especially I just thought about the intellectual disability, and second, in the attitude to persons with disabilities, and the third area of changes in the perception of developmental potential of people with intellectual disability and the chance to live with dignity. This is the attitudes towards people with disabilities. So this is from treating people with disability, with intellectual disability as an object to subjectivity, from focusing on impairments to searching for strengths, from practicing different function to reinforcing mechanism of self-rehabilitation, from searching limitation in the functioning of people with disability in the environment to removing barriers and difficulties which they can encounter in the environment. And changes in the comprehension of the essence of disability from a static category, intellectual disability as a static category to a dynamic category of disability, from regarding intellectual disability as a feature to regarding it as a condition which can change, from intellectual disability permanently attributed to the person to a chance to get beyond disability, from a single factor etiology to multi-factor etiology, from generalized judgments of difficulties in solving problems to the difficulties experienced by a person in a given situation and in a given moment. And okay, and changes in rehabilitation of education of person with disability. Also, we can observe just such kind of direction from education of compensating for deficits to humanistic education, humanistic approach, from looking for diversifying features to perceiving common features, from segregated education away from the place of residence to inclusive education in the place of residence, from education outside the family to education in the family and practicing for independent life, from action oriented at individual to family therapy, from actions oriented at a student and young adult to therapy and education for a person from their birth to old age, and from being socially useful to independence and fulfillment of one's own life goals. So there are three areas of changes which I defined, and of course all changes influences of system of education. Thank you.